When head of Microsoft's Xbox division, Phil Spencer, took the stage at E3 and said the company's presentation would be all about games this year, he wasn't kidding. For the next 90 minutes, the company showed trailer after trailer of exclusive titles that would come to the Xbox One console over the next year. Halo, the Master Chief Collection, available in November, will include 45 campaign missions and more than 100 multiplayer maps in what is one of the iconic franchises for the platform.
This is actually one of my favorite maps. You've got some great sight lines. You can really see the vistas popping here as well. Okay, there we go.
Forza Motorsport 5 adds one of the world's most famous racetracks, the Nürburgring. The track has been laser scanned to millimeter accuracy. And Tom Clancy's The Division puts players in a post-pandemic New York City that has collapsed into chaos following a deadly disease. It will debut in 2015.
Find cover, find cover. Ooh, watch out, watch out, watch out.
Holy crap.
There they are.
There's loads of them.
I can't get a shot. Try and hit them from the right.
Can't. I'm gonna switch my weapon.
Okay, I got you. I'm moving up.
Microsoft spent much of its time on games for good reason. Once the king of the console wars, Microsoft has found itself in a new position, second place to Sony's PlayStation 4. Last year at E3, Microsoft spent much of its time on features of the Xbox One other than gaming.
I think Microsoft got some pushback last year from the way they introduced Xbox One, that it wasn't gaming-centric, and they were like, where are the games? And what Sony did was more centered on AAA games and the exclusive games and gamers first and all that stuff. In terms of the non-gaming stuff, I mean, I think that's really important, right? The community stuff, like I said, Twitch streaming services of gameplay, the video downloads and being able to play, you know, music through it and all these sorts of things. I think that that's an important nice to have, but I don't think it is the centerpiece as to why people buy these consoles. Our survey data shows that, you know, the games catalog and the price are they're both like critical buying factors in the decision, right? And some of the online services are much lower in terms of why people buy the systems.
Since the launch of Xbox One in November, Microsoft has taken an about-face on the inclusion of a Kinect sensor. It has since unbundled Kinect and dropped the price to $399, allowing it to better compete with the PlayStation 4. During its E3 presentation this year, it made no mention of the Kinect sensor. Nick Barber, IDG News Service.